play for the 13th and final time by hosting the preseason favorites to win it all in the conference this year, the Coyotes from the University of South Dakota. Good afternoon, everybody. Belated Merry Christmas and Happy New Year to one and all. I'm Mike Moss, courtside here at Arnie Ball Court. Glad you could join us on YouTube for this latest edition of Purdue-Fort Wayne women's basketball. Macedons have finished non-league play for the 2019-20 season. Their last outing was on December 22nd down in Indianapolis when they took on the Butler Bulldogs. And shooting woes affected the Dons on that Sunday. And they ended up losing to Butler by a final score of 85-58. Thus, they complete the non-league portion of their schedule with a record of 4-9. Meanwhile, their opponents today, the Coyotes from the University of South Dakota, well, to say that they're a pretty good basketball team would be an understatement. They come into this matchup ranked 24th in one poll and just out of the top 25 in the other. They have a 12-2 overall record, which includes their first game in the Summit League, which took place last Sunday over in Macomb, Illinois, where they knocked off the Leathernecks from Western Illinois by a score of 96-65. South Dakota, led by the preseason Player of the Year in the Summit League, Kira Duffy. Kira is a 6-foot senior out of Rapid City, Dakota. He comes into this matchup averaging 16.5 points, just under 6 rebounds, and 5 assists per contest. She's also picked up 3 block shots and 13 steals, but to say that she's all by herself would be a huge understatement. Hannah Shervin, second in scoring at 12 points a game, almost 6.5 rebounds, and she's blocked 29 shots. And a third member of the team in double digits scoring-wise, that's Chloe Lamb, just over 11 points a game and just under 11 rebounds a game. As a team, South Dakota averaging just under 82 points a contest, giving up just under 64. For the Purdue-Fort Wayne Mastodons, they are led in scoring by senior Hannah Albrecht, who did not play in the game at Butler on the 22nd. Hannah averaging 15 points a game, also a little over 3 rebounds and 2 assists. One other member of the team in double figures, that's senior Anna Lappenkooper from Germany. At Butler, she tied her career high with 22 points in the effort against the Bulldogs. Anna averaging almost 11 points a game, and twice this year she has hit 22 points in one contest. Purdue-Fort Wayne scoring under 58 points a game while giving up just over 65. Team's just finishing up their warm-up session. In about a minute, we will have the playing of the national anthem. 19th meeting all time between these two teams. The series began on December 1st, 2011, right here in Fort Wayne. And the Macedons came out on top, 60-63. They then lost their next two meetings in Vermilion, South Dakota, by scores of 70-56, 82-51, and came back and won in February of 2013 and January of 2014 to take a 3-2 lead in the season series. But ever since then, it's been all South Dakota, as the Coyotes have won the last 13 games in a row. Thus, they lead the series 15-3. They will play today, and they will play later on in Vermilion. Time now to have the playing of our national anthem. international anthem brought to you today by Midwest America Federal Credit Union. Now time now to bring you today's starting lineups. They are brought to you by Evans Toyota. Start your life in a Toyota Camry today for the visiting Coyotes from South Dakota. At one guard will be Monica Arnes, a 5'9 junior from Crofton, Nebraska. At another guard will be Chloe Lamb, a 5'10 junior from Oneida, South Dakota. The third guard in their four-guard offense is Madison McKeever, a 5'6 senior from Erskine, Minnesota. Guard number four, Kira Duffy, again the preseason player of the year pick in the Summit League, a 6-foot senior from Rapid City, South Dakota. And in the middle will be Hannah Shervin, a 6'3 junior from Rogers, Minnesota. The head coach at South Dakota is Don Plitzuwhite. The associate head coach is Jason Jeske. Assistant coaches Aaron Horn and Jana Schlafke. With Alex Antonin, the director of basketball operations. Video montage playing on the big boards here inside the Arnie Ball court. Momentarily, we'll have the introduction of the starting lineup for the Purdue Fort Wayne Mastodons. I also want to mention that Don Plitzuwhite's overall record, he's also coached at Grand Valley State and Northern Kentucky. 279 wins and 117 defeats. Now the starting lineup for Purdue Fort Wayne. At one guard will be Shayla Sellers, a 6-foot freshman from Aurora, Ohio. At another guard will be Hannah Albrecht. Again, Hannah, a 5'7", fifth-year senior from Crown Point, Indiana, came to Purdue Fort Wayne from the now-closed St. Joseph's College over in Rensselaer, Indiana. Third guard in the three-guard offense, Anna Lappenkooper, a 5'9", senior from Herne, Germany. Up front, Ellie Dykstra, a 6'1", sophomore from Byron Center, Michigan, not too far from Grand Rapids. And also getting the start up front, Chatoya Sanders, a fifth-year senior from right here in Fort Wayne, played her high school basketball at Wayne High School, started out collegiately at Chicago State, and after 2 years with the Cougars, transferred here to Purdue Fort Wayne. The head coach at Purdue Fort Wayne is Niecy Nelson. In her fourth season, her record is 20-79. Assisted by Marcy Alberts, Haley Seibert, and Keela Sims, who we hope to talk to in our post-game show with Kendall Festervon, the graduate manager. Our officials this afternoon, Mark Berger, Jamie Broderick, and Brad Maxey. Mastodons in the home white. They'll be going from right to left in the first half. South Dakota in the visiting red with white trim and numbers. Sanders and Shervin in the circle, and the opening tap is controlled by South Dakota. So here we go on New Year's Day. On the left side, Lamb, and they get it to Duffy. Misses a short jumper, rebounded by Hannah Albrecht. Up the left side to Dykstra, and she dragged her pivot foot. First turnover on Purdue Fort Wayne. We've played all of 21 seconds. No score. Chloe Lamb, high post pass to Duffy. Watched by Sellers. Looks like Purdue Fort Wayne starting out in the man-to-man. Shervin watched by Chatoya Sanders. Back to Duffy on the left side. 12 on the shot clock. Pull-up jumper. Off the rim, no good by Monica Arnes. Putback is good by Shervin. So South Dakota scores the game's first points, and they are on top 2-0. Dykstra on the left wing, top of the key to Sanders. Now she takes two dribbles, looks for help, kicks it down the left side to Dykstra. Wants to go baseline, cut off. Back to Lappenkooper, now to Albrecht. 8 on the shot clock. Albrecht inside Sanders. Turnaround jumper, good. And the Mastodons are going to need some inside presence from Chatoya Sanders if they're going to be successful here this afternoon. 2-2 our score, 90 seconds in. Monica Irons, foul line extended left, top of the key to Duffy. Now they go right side to Lamb, and we got a whistle. Let's see who Brad Max is going to call. They're going to call foul on Chatoya Sanders, her first, team first, non-shooting foul. So Coyotes will inbound the ball underneath their own basket. Lob pass into Irons, and player control foul going to be called on Hannah Shervin. Her first, team first. So Purdue Fort Wayne will get the basketball back. 8:25 left, first quarter. We're tied at two here on New Year's Day. Game one in conference play for Purdue Fort Wayne. Game two in conference play for South Dakota. Sanders, top of the key. Now they get it to Albrecht. Back up to Lopp and Cooper. Snap pass to Dykstra. 12 on the shot clock. Back to Albrecht. Inside, and she travels. She passed the ball to Sanders. Second turnover on Purdue Fort Wayne. Less than 8 minutes now remain in the first half. Duffy inside, Shervin off the glass and in. Hannah Shervin now with all four South Dakota points. They're on top 4-2. 7:41 left, first quarter. Lopp and Cooper hands the ball off to Albrecht. Back to Anna Lopp and Cooper on the right side. Give and go to Albrecht, cut off by Duffy. Hannah with the dribble, brings the top of the key. Tries to create some space, cannot. Passes it to Lopp and Cooper. Inside to Sanders, snap left corner to Sellers. And Sellers called for a travel for the second time today. That's the third turnover on Purdue Fort Wayne, all traveling violations. So here come the Coyotes, left to right, wearing the red uniforms with white trim and numbers and lettering. Chloe Lamb, pull-up jumper, off the rim, no good. Ball knocked out of bounds, last touch by Shervin. She was dueling Shayla Sellers for that rebound. Macedon's inbounded at the 7:12 mark, first quarter. Lopp and Cooper over midcourt. Watched by McKeever. Gives it to Albrecht. Drives the lane. Shot blocked. Whistle and a foul. Foul's going to be called on Chloe Lamb, her first, team second. And coming in for South Dakota is Taylor Frederick, a 6'1 senior from Erling, Iowa. At the line for Purdue Fort Wayne is Hannah Albrecht. We mentioned averaging 15 points a game. She's also hitting 83% of her free throws, and I jinxed her because she missed the first of two. One more coming for the fifth-year senior. And that one is good. So Albrecht with her first points, a 4-3 score. Couple of substitutions for Purdue Fort Wayne. Hannah Hess and Jazzy Hughes. Hess a 5'10 fourth year junior from Oregon, Ohio. And Jazzy Hughes, a transfer, 6-foot junior from Tucson, Arizona. Lob pass into Frederick. Left-hand shot off the glass and in. Taylor Frederick with her first 2 points. South Dakota on top 6-3. 6:40 left, first quarter. Hess. Left side pass to Sellers. Sellers picked up by Duffy. Now they go back on the right side. Lopp and Cooper. Hess, left side three. Yes! Hannah Hess with her first points off the bench. And we're tied at six with 6:20 to go here in quarter number one. Kira Duffy watched by Sellers. Top of the key. Dribbles to the right. Drives the lane. Shoots over Hughes. Off the glass. No good. Fight for the rebound. Picked up by Frederick. Get it back up top. Three-point shot by Monica Irons. Rattles the rim and drops through. Irons with her first points. Coyotes on top 9-6. Just under 6 minutes left here in the first quarter. Lopp and Cooper. Right side pass to Hess. Hannah Hess dribbles to the left. Gets it off to Dykstra. Dykstra near the foul line. Gives it to Dribble. Looks for help. Gets it to Lopp and Cooper. Lopp and Cooper on the right wing to Dykstra. Elway's going to drive the lane, loses the ball. Picked up by Frederick. Three on one. Frederick Oh, she double dribbled, didn't get it called, and now that's a kick ball. South Dakota's going to get the benefit of the doubt and get keep possession. Lob pass into Duffy, watched by Hughes, driving the lane, left-hand shot is good. Kira Duffy, averaging over 16 points a game, picks up her first 2 points of the ball game. 11-6, South Dakota on a 5-0 run right now, leading with 5:15 left here in the first quarter. Dykstra, top of the key, hands it off to Hess. Hess, cut off by Lamb, gives it to Lappin-Cooper now. Albrecht on the left side. Eight on the shot clock. Hannah Albrecht dribbles to the right, loses, picks it back up. Three on the shot clock, loses it. Stolen by Chloe Lamb, driving all the way. The left hand on the shot, off the rim, no good. And it looks like Jamie Broderick is going to call a foul on Anna Lappin-Cooper. Her first, team second. And we have a timeout on the floor. 4 minutes and 51 seconds left here in the first quarter. Our score, South Dakota 11, Purdue Fort Wayne 6. From Arnie Ball Court, this is Purdue Fort Wayne women's basketball.
Life is busy. Most days you wake up, make the coffee, get the kids dressed, and get them out the door. With everything else there is to do in a day, finding a doctor can take a lot of time. You have to ask your friends for recommendations, search online, sort through results, and make a dozen phone calls. Lutheran Health Network now makes it possible to find a doctor with just one phone call. All you need is a single phone number, 844-LHN-DOCS. That's right, with one phone call, you can schedule an appointment with one of more than 50 primary care providers in the Lutheran Health Network. And with 20 locations throughout Allen County, there's a Lutheran Health physician close to you. Call 844-LHN-DOCS to find a new doctor or make an appointment. Finding a doctor with just one phone call? That's life. Powered by Lutheran. Lutheran Health Network includes physician-owned hospitals.
Welcome back, everybody, to Arnie Ball Court here inside the Hilliard Gate Sports Center. 4:51 left here in the first quarter. South Dakota leading Purdue Fort Wayne 11-6. Coyotes have the ball underneath their own basket. They have hit 5 of their 10 shots from the floor, including 1 3-pointer. Purdue Fort Wayne's only taken 2 shots. They've hit them both. One of those, a 3-point field goal as well. Inside move, Duffy, turnaround jumper, no good. Rebounded Jazzy Hughes. I mentioned that Liv Corngable in the ballgame for South Dakota at the timeout. Hughes to Lappin-Cooper. Lappin-Cooper dribbles to her left in the paint. Pullback jumper, off the glass, no good. Rebounded by Taylor Frederick. Frederick, pass intended for Madison McKeever, knocked out of bounds by Lappin-Cooper. It stays with South Dakota. 4:27 left here in the first half. Kira Duffy to inbound it right in front of us. Gets it into Madison McKeever. McKeever back to Duffy on the right side. Now looks like Purdue Fort Wayne in a little bit of a zone. Pull-up jumper. No good by McKeever. Rebounded Hughes. Outlet pass. Lappin-Cooper ahead to Albrecht. Hannah Albrecht. Snap pass top of the key to Hughes. Hughes hands it off to Lappin-Cooper. Now passes to Hess, left side three, off the rim, no good. Duffy with the rebound. Back comes South Dakota, leading 11-6 with less than 4 minutes remaining in the first quarter. Pull-up jumper is good by Monica Arnn. She now has 5 points. 13-6, South Dakota. 3:42 left, first quarter. Hannah Hess with the ball for Purdue Fort Wayne to Hughes. Hughes, left side pass to Albrecht, watched by Duffy. Back to Hughes. Takes one dribble, jumper good. And Jazzy was shocked when all of a sudden she had a wide open target. So it's 13-8. South Dakota on top. Duffy watched by Hess, top of the key. Dribbles to her left. Lob pass on the left block for Frederick. Shooting over Sanders. Shot off the rim, no good. Toya with the rebound. Hands it off to Lappin-Cooper. Ahead to Hannah Albrecht. Albrecht Back to Loppen Cooper, dribbles to her left. Now passes in the corner to Hess. Back to Loppen Cooper, 3 minutes left, first quarter. Hannah Hess with 12 on the shot clock. Gets it to Loppen Cooper, she'll launch a three. That's off the iron, no good. Sanders, offensive rebound. Kicks it back out to Albrecht, to Loppen Cooper, and they'll rerun the offense. 2:42 left in the quarter. Hess on the left wing to Hughes, eight in the shot clock. Skip pass right side, Albrecht. Long jumper, off the iron, no good. Rebound pulled down by Madison McKeever. Long pass to Duffy. Pull up jumper, off the rim, too strong. No good, Hannah Hess with the rebound, hands it off to Loppen Cooper. Back we go. Purdue Fort Wayne going right to left, back to Hess. Three on the way, that's off the front of the rim. Long rebound pulled down by Liv Horngable. Gable over midcourt. Ball knocked away by Sanders, picked up by Hess. Good defense by the Mastodons. Albrecht up the right side of the floor. Gives it back to Loppen Cooper. 2 minutes to go in the quarter. 13-8, Coyotes leading Purdue Fort Wayne. Albrecht, right side, lob pass. Sanders in the block, off the glass and in. Sanders from Hannah Albrecht. Toya's second bucket. It's 13-10. And we got a foul to boot. And the foul is going to be called on Monica Arns. Her first, team third. So Shatoya Sanders a chance for a conventional three-point play. Toya's been bothered by injuries in her short stint here in Fort Wayne. 72% free throw shooter. And this one is good. So Sanders with a three-point play brings the Mastodons to within two. They trail 13-11, 1:48 left in the quarter. Now Purdue Fort Wayne goes to a 1-2-1-1 full court press. Kira Duffy says, I'm going to break it. And she does. Crossing midcourt, watched by Sellers. Left side pass to Corngable. Picked up by Riley Ott, freshman out of LaPorte. Now Shervin back in the ballgame. Goes wide left, misses on a three-point shot. And the ball goes back over to Purdue Fort Wayne. 1:31 left in the quarter. South Dakota 13, Purdue Fort Wayne 11. Riley Ott, a talented guard out of LaPorte, Indiana, brings it up over midcourt. She's watched by Claudia Kunzer, who's in for South Dakota. Ott, bounce pass in the block to Hughes. Hughes double team, back to Ott. 12 on the shot clock. Ott skips it back, Loppen Cooper now to Albrecht. Back to Ott, gonna travel. Oh, she did travel. She tried to break in towards the basket. That's the fourth traveling call on Purdue Fort Wayne this quarter. So South Dakota gets it back with 70 seconds left in the first quarter, leading 13-11. Kira Duffy, watched by Ott. Size mismatch in favor of South Dakota there. Corngable picked up by Albrecht. Lob pass intended for Duffy, knocked away. And they're going to call a foul on Shayla Sellers. Her first, team third. Comes with 56 seconds in the quarter, so South Dakota will maintain possession of the basketball. Macy Nelson, Purdue Fort Wayne head coach, talking with Brad Maxey on that call. Who's going to inbound it? It'll be Liv Corngable. Corngable, by the way, a 5'9 junior from Rochester, Minnesota. Front of the Mastodon bench. Lob pass to Shervin, back to Duffy. Long jumper off the rim, no good. Jazzy Hughes with the rebound to Loppen Cooper. 45 seconds left in the quarter. Purdue Fort Wayne trailing 13-11. They can tie it with the deuce, take the lead with the tray. Albrecht between the circles. 15 on the shot clock. Hannah Albrecht now on the right side. Kicks it back out to Loppen Cooper. 10 on the shot clock. Loppen Cooper loses the ball to Duffy. Duffy gets it back to Kunzer. Back to Duffy, who crosses midcourt with 22 seconds left in the quarter. Don Plitzer-White saying, one shot, one shot. Duffy picked up by Albrecht. 13 seconds on the shot clock. 15, now down to 10 seconds and a quarter. Duffy attacks, pulls up, gets it back. Top of the key three, no good by Lamb. Rebound fought for. And the quarter comes to an end as good hustle by Riley Ott and Liv Corngable a pair of number twos. 10 minutes in the books. And after 10 minutes is our score, South Dakota 13, Purdue Fort Wayne 11. Quarter number two coming up momentarily is from Arnie Ball Court. This is Purdue Fort Wayne women's basketball.
Hi, I'm Rick Evans with Evans Toyota. Many dealers talk about customer satisfaction, but we live it. And we're willing to back it up. We want the Evans experience to be the best experience you can have every time you are here, whether it's in sales or in service. So we have installed red phone hotlines throughout the entire dealership. Pick up any of the red phones, and it will ring to my personal cell phone. If your Evans experience is not everything that you think it should be, I want to know. I believe in your complete satisfaction so much that I give you immediate access to me no matter where I am. So stop in. Check out our huge sale. And if you are not completely satisfied, call me and let me see if I can help. It's Evans Toyota, corner of Coliseum and Lima Road, or evanstoyota.com. And be sure to like us on Facebook for special discounts and giveaways.
Well, welcome back, everybody, to Purdue Fort Wayne. Massanutten trailing South Dakota after one quarter of play, 13-11. South Dakota has only hit one of their last eight shots in the floor. They were 6 of 18 from the floor in the quarter. Massanutten's a windbound the basketball. Shayla Sellers, Riley Ott, Hannah Albrecht, Shatoya Sanders, and Anna Loppenkooper on the floor. Sanders hands it off to Ott, and Ott called for a travel. Purdue Fort Wayne has now turned the ball over eight times. Six of those eight times are a traveling violation. Chloe Lamb brings the ball up over midcourt, watched by Loppenkooper, looks for Duffy to the left, instead passes it to McKeever on the right. And now, turnabout fair play. Liv Corngable commits a traveling violation. Hannah Hess checks in for Anna Loppenkooper for Purdue Fort Wayne. When these two teams met last February here in Fort Wayne, Purdue Fort Wayne actually led after one quarter, 17-14, and the teams were tied at halftime, 34 apiece. Sanders on the right block in the left corner. Albrecht, three, off the rim, short. Ott gets the offensive board. Tries to get Sanders underneath. Loose ball out of bounds, two. Purdue Fort Wayne. Conference opener for the Mastodons. Game 14 overall. Inside pass to Sanders, back to Ott. Baseline jumper, good. Riley Ott with her first points. And we're tied at 13, 50 seconds into the second quarter. Back comes South Dakota. Kira Duffy, top of the key, watched by Sanders. Inside pass to Lamb, kicks it back into the left corner. Three ball is good by Corngable. Corngable puts South Dakota back on top, 16-13. Back come the Purdue Fort Wayne Mastodons, wearing the home white uniforms. Ott cut off at the baseline, brings it back out, hands it off to Hannah Hess. Hess thought about a three. She's already hit one of those today, gives it instead to Hannah Albrecht. Albrecht lob pass to Sanders. Ball knocked away, picked up by Chloe Lamb. Ninth turnover on Purdue Fort Wayne. Lamb on the right wing to Corngable, watched by Hess. Snap pass back, left side inside Shervin. Shot knocked away, altered by Shatoya Sanders. Here's Albrecht, back to Ott. Ott penetrates, kicks it in the left corner. Hess for three, no, off the rim, no good. Hannah Shervin with the rebound. Back and forth we go, a pace that I really think favors South Dakota at this juncture. Corngable, top of the key. Wants to rub off a Shervin pick. Pushes off Ott, no call. Now Shervin drives to the basket and is fouled. Fouls on Riley Ott. Her first, team first of the quarter. clock stop with 7:47 left in this second quarter. At the free throw line will be Hannah Shervin. Shervin had 4 points in the first quarter. 65% free throw shooter on the year, and she misses the first. That was the first free throw attempt in the ball game by South Dakota. Shervin, averaging 12 points a game, hits the second. She now has 5 points overall. South Dakota 17, Purdue Fort Wayne 13. 7:40 left here in the second quarter from Fort Wayne, Indiana. Hannah Hess on the left side. Now dribbles between the circles. Watched by Kira Duffy to Sellers. Sellers gives it off to Jazzy Hughes in the trees. Wrap around, hook shot, good. Jazzy Hughes with her second bucket. Purdue Fort Wayne at this juncture hanging in there. They're down just two, 17-15. Just over 7 minutes left in the first half. Corn Gable watched by Ott. Now top of the key pass to McKeever. Jumper good. Madison McKeever with her first points in the ball game. 19-15, the Coyote advantage is four. Just under 7 minutes left here in the first half. Hannah Hess on the left side. Watched by Kira Duffy, dribbles to her right. Now, pulls up, 3-point shot, good! Second triple for Hannah Hess. And the Dons pull within one. They trail 19-18, just over 6.5 minutes left here in the second quarter. McKeever hounded by Lappincooper, now picked up by Sellers. Dribbling inside, dribbles back out. 13 on the shot clock, now Corn Gable. Jazzy Hughes cut in front of Shervin, knocked the ball away, but they're gonna call Jazzy for the foul. Her first, team second. South Dakota will maintain possession as Shatoya Sanders comes back onto the floor, replacing Shayla Sellers. Coyotes will inbound the ball underneath their own basket, leading by a single point, 19-18. Inbounds pass to Duffy, driving on Hughes, and what are they going to say? They're going to say Jazzy Hughes with the push-off. Two quick fouls on Hughes, and that'll bring Ellie Dykstra off the bench. Now three team fouls in the quarter on Purdue Fort Wayne. Chloe Lamb to inbound it. Lob pass back to Duffy. Now top of the key to McKeever. McKeever watched by Hess. Left side pass to Lamb. She's picked up by Dykstra. Now back to Shervin on top. Now they work on the perimeter. Give and go to Shervin. Right side. Pull up jumper short. Rebound Shatoya Sanders of Purdue Fort Wayne. Hands it off to Anna Lappincooper. Up the right side to Riley Ott. Back to Lappincooper. Dribbles to the top of the key. Dribbles to the left. Looks for help. Passes in the left corner to Hess. Back to Lappincooper. 15 on the shot clock. Dykstra attacks the lane. Double team back to Hess. Right side, Ott. 8 on the clock. Shot partially blocked and picked up by Shervin. McKeever picked up at midcourt by Lappincooper. 5:35 left in the half, and an errant pass by South Dakota. We'll give the ball back over to Purdue Fort Wayne. Monica Arnes and Taylor Frederick check in for the Coyotes. Corn Gable and Shervin check out. 5:34 left on the second quarter clock. Purdue Fort Wayne trailing by just one, 19-18 to the 24th ranked team in the country, South Dakota. Riley Ott, top of the key pass Sanders. She launches a three off the rim, no good. The long rebound pulled down by Madison McKeever. Outlet pass up the left side to Arnes. Oh, Arnes did a push-off, did a travel, missed the shot. Sanders with the rebound. Back come the Mastodons, right to left. Out up the right side of the floor to Lappincooper. Back to Riley Ott, dribbles to the left. Pull-up jumper from the foul line. Misses the shot, but draws the foul. Foul's going to be on Madison McKeever. Her first, team first of the quarter. And we have a timeout on the floor. 4:59 left here in the second quarter. Our score, South Dakota 19, Purdue Fort Wayne 18. Dons with a chance to take the lead from the line when we return. As from Arnie Ball Court, this is Purdue Fort Wayne women's basketball.
When it comes to breast health, early detection is key. At Lutheran Health Network, we offer mammography services at 9 convenient imaging locations throughout the region. Many locations offer 3D mammograms. No referral necessary. To learn more and schedule your mammogram, visit lutheranhealth.net/mammography. That's life, powered by Lutheran.
In its fourth decade, the Summit League continues its ascent through excellence in the classroom and success in the field of play. In cities big and small, at public and private universities, more than 120,000 students across 9 institutions reach for the Summit. From academic All-Americans to NCAA champions and nationally ranked teams, Summit League student athletes achieve the pinnacle of success. The Summit League, where tomorrow's leaders reach the summit today.
Welcome back, everybody, to Arnie Ball Court. 4:59 left here in the second quarter. And Riley Ott, the freshman from LaPorte, Indiana, hits the first of two free throws to tie the game at 19. Ott now with 3 points and 4 points on the day as she knocks down the second one, and the Macedons have a one-point lead. Now they go to a full court, 1-2-2 press. Duffy to McKeever over midcourt. Bounce pass back to Kira Duffy, back to McKeever. Left side to Monica Arns. A three ball off the front of the rim, no good. Rebound picked up by Hannah Hess of Purdue Fort Wayne. The redshirt junior brings it over midcourt herself. She's already hit a couple of threes. Cut off by Duffy. She wants to go baseline. Looks for help. And it's knocked out of bounds. Fortuitous break, as it'll stay with Purdue Fort Wayne. On a lop, and Cooper will inbound. Somebody's got to inbound it. Somebody. Now it'll be Riley Ott. Looking for Sanders. She's double teamed. Looks for somebody. Kicks it back out to Lop and Cooper. Launching a three. Off the rim, no good. Rebound, McKeever. McKeever brings it up over midcourt herself. Dribbles to the right. Picked up by Lop and Cooper. Left side pass to Arns. Now on the left corner to Lamb, back to Kira Duffy. Duffy thought about a three, attacks the lane instead, cut off by Sanders. Oh, nice pass to Frederick. Shot partially blocked by Sanders, who kicked it off of Frederick's arms out of bounds. Good defense by Shatoya Sanders. Turnover, South Dakota. So Purdue Fort Wayne a chance to add to their one-point lead. They're up 20-19 with 4:06 left here in the second quarter. Ott over midcourt, right side pass to Hess, watched by Duffy. In give and go, Sanders tried to hit Dykstra, but the pass over Ellie's head out of bounds. That'll be a Mastodon turnover. They now have turned it over 11 times. Less than 3 minutes remain here in the first half. Purdue Fort Wayne leading South Dakota by 1 point. Give and go to Arns underneath. Shot no good. Sanders with the board for Purdue Fort Wayne. Outlet pass Lappencooper. Left side pass to Ott. Ott wants to go left baseline. Kicks it instead. Hess, a three from the right corner. Good! Hannah Hess with 3 3-point field goals. Biggest lead of the day for the Mastodons. It's 4-23-19. 3:22 left, first half. Kira Duffy wants to take matters into her own hands. Oh, nice pass. Frederick left all alone under the basket. Frederick with her second bucket. 23-21. Purdue Fort Wayne by two. 3:05 left in the second quarter. Lappencooper on the left side. Now a left side pass to Ott. Back to Lappencooper. Top of the key to Hess. Fakes the three. Drives it in. Kicks it off to Lappencooper. 10 on the shot clock. And Hess called for a travel. .250 left until intermission. Mastodons 23, Coyotes 21. Duffy on the right side, picked up by Ott. Back top of the key to Lamb, left side to McKeever. McKeever driving on Dykstra. Cut off, back to Duffy. Duffy inside for Frederick again, all alone, getting past Sanders. Taylor Frederick with a half a dozen. And the Coyotes have come back and tied the game at 23. They have scored on a couple of Frederick two-point field goals to get that tie. 2:20 left in the half. Hess, left wing pass to Dykstra, top of the key, Sanders. Sanders wants to go right side, drives the lane and knocks it off the glass and in. Sanders with 7 points. Purdue Fort Wayne back on top, 25-23. As we near the two-minute mark, time left in the second quarter. Lamb all alone, right side three is good. Nope, we're caught a long two. Lamb in the book with 2 points. Knotted at 25, 1:48. Time left first half. Hannah Hess, right wing pass to Dykstra. Dykstra, top of the key to Sanders. Sanders now gives it to Loppenkooper. Loppenkooper watched by McKeever. Dribbles to her right. Lob pass Sanders, high post, turnaround jumper. Off the glass, no good. Rebounded by Monica Arns. Coyotes with a chance to retake the lead and a pull. Oh, they're going to call a foul on Loppenkooper. And Mark Berger didn't see the push off by Monica with the left arm. Second foul on Anna Loppenkooper. Fourth team foul on Purdue Fort Wayne. Clock stop with 1:28 left in the quarter. Jazzy Hughes checks in for Purdue Fort Wayne, replacing Loppenkooper, who has two personal fouls. Sellers back in as well. Ott, Sellers, Hughes, Albrecht, and Sanders. Chloe Lamb with the ball for South Dakota. Now to Duffy. Duffy wants to go to work on Ott. Drives lane, cut off by Sanders. Back to Frederick. She'll launch a three. In and out, no good. Sanders with the board. Outlet pass, Riley Ott. Left side pass to Albrecht. Albrecht, who leads the team in scoring at 15 points a game, held to just one so far here today. Final minute of play in the first half. Mastodons tied 25-all with South Dakota. Hughes, top of the key, 10 on the shot clock. Inside pass to Sanders. Deflected pass to Albrecht. 5 on the shot clock. Arching shot off the rim, no. Duffy with the rebound. Duffy up the floor, right up the gut. Pull-up jumper over Sanders is good. Kira Duffy with her 4th point. Gives South Dakota a 2-point lead, 27-25. 2-second differential, shot clock and game clock. We're down to 22 seconds in the half. Riley Ott just over midcourt, dribbling the basketball. Watched by McKeever from a distance of about 10 feet. Down to 10 on the shot clock. Here we go. Ott drives the lane. Shot off the glass. No good. Rebound, Kira Duffy. 5 seconds, 4 seconds over midcourt. Left side pass to Arns. Arns, ball knocked away. Picked up by Hughes, and the horn sounds to end the first half of play. Tremendous effort put on by both teams here on this New Year's Day. In the second quarter, each team scored 14 points. So as the teams head into their respective locker rooms, our halftime score, South Dakota 27, Purdue Fort Wayne 25. We'll take a break, come back and review what's happened thus far. Again, it's the Coyotes on top of the Mastodons 27-25. We're at halftime as from Arnie Ball Court. This is Purdue Fort Wayne women's basketball.
Truths brought to you by Geico.
Technology Truths.
Truth, you talk faster when your phone has only 1% battery left.
Hey, hon, what's up?
Hey, sweetie, can you pick up Kitty Litter Fabric Softener? Oh, the lemony fresh kind. And French Vanilla Non-Dairy Creamer on your way home from work.
What?
Truth, it's so easy to switch and save on car insurance at Geico.com.
Why are you talking like that?
Gotta go. I'm taking Kevin to Taekwondo and I only have a...
Honey? Hello?
Geico, 15 minutes could save you 15% or more.
Life is busy enough. And when you add finding a doctor, it can be overwhelming. Lutheran Health Network now makes it possible to find a doctor with just one phone call to 844-LHN-DOCS. One call lets you schedule an appointment with one of more than 50 primary care providers in our network. Just call 844-LHN-DOCS. Finding a doctor with just one call, that's life, powered by Lutheran. Lutheran Health Network includes physician-owned hospitals.
Facing an illness or injury that can't wait?
turn to ReadyMed. We're ready when your day doesn't go quite as planned, with convenient hours 7 days a week. We offer after-hours appointments as well as x-ray and lab services in each of our convenient area locations. From minor accidents and injuries to fevers and flus, we're ready. To learn more, check wait times, and save your spot in line, visit ReadyMed.com. In case of a life-threatening emergency, call 911 or go to the nearest emergency department as soon as possible.
In its fourth decade, the Summit League continues its ascent through excellence in the classroom and success in the field of play. In cities big and small, at public and private universities, more than 120,000 students across 9 institutions reach for the Summit. From academic All-Americans to NCAA champions and nationally ranked teams, Summit League student athletes achieve the pinnacle of success. The Summit League, where tomorrow's leaders reach the Summit today.
Welcome back, everybody, to Arnie Ball Court here inside the Hilliard Gates Sports Center on the campus of Purdue-Fort Wayne University. I'm Mike Maz. It is halftime in our matchup between the Purdue-Fort Wayne Mastodons, starting their 13th and final year of Summit League play, and the South Dakota Coyotes, the preseason favorites to win everything in the Summit League. And at halftime, it is a two-point game. South Dakota on top, 27-25. Game started out inside play. Hannah Shervin hit the first two buckets for South Dakota. Shatoya Sanders responded with one bucket for Purdue Fort Wayne. Hannah Albrecht hit one of two at the line. At that point, it was a 4-3 game. Taylor Frederick scored to make it 6-3. And then Hannah Hess from the left corner drained a three to tie the game at six. And then USD went on a bit of a run. They went on a 7-point run to go on top, 13-6. But Mastodons responded by scoring the last 5 points of the quarter. So after one quarter of play, it was 13-11 in favor of South Dakota. And then we started going back and forth. And aided by a couple of more three-point field goals by Hannah Hess, the redshirt junior from Oregon, Ohio. South Dakota at one point led 19-18. And then Riley Ott, coming out of a timeout, hit two free throws, gave Purdue Fort Wayne their first lead of the game at 20-19. Hess hit another three to stretch the lead to four at 23-19. But South Dakota came right back as Frederick was all alone underneath. Got a couple of nice passes, one of them from Kira Duffy. And the two layups tied the game at 23. And we were tied at 23, we were tied at 25, but Duffy scored right before the end of the half to give South Dakota their 2-point lead. Taking a look at some of the numbers in the first half, South Dakota 12 of 31 from the floor for just under 39%, 2 of 6 from 3-point range for 33%, 1 of 2 at the foul line for 50%. Coyotes led in scoring by Taylor Frederick with 6 points, Hannah Shervin, Monica Arns each with 5, Kira Duffy, who averages almost 16.5 points a game, held to just 4. 3 points for Liv Corngable, and two apiece scored by Chloe Lamb and Madison McKeever. Claudia Kunzer played for just under 2 minutes, but did not score. For the Mastodons, they were 9 of 21 from the floor for just under 43%. And this is a team that has had trouble making baskets all year long, so to hit just under 43% is really good. Well, it's not so good. 3 of 12 from behind the three-point arc for just 25%. But Purdue Fort Wayne has hit 4 of their 5 free throws for 80%. They are led in scoring by Hannah Hess. Again, the redshirt junior from Oregon, Ohio, just outside of Toledo. Hannah, 3 of 6 on the floor. All her shots, all her makes from three-point range. That's 9 points. 7 points from Shatoya Sanders, 3 of 5 from the floor, 1 of 1 from the line. 4 points scored by Jazzy Hughes, 4 points scored by the freshman Riley Ott, and 1 point scored by Hannah Albrecht. Again, Hannah leads the team in scoring at 15 points a game, held to just 1 here in the first half. Ellie Dykstra, Shayla Sellers, and Anna Lappencooper played but did not score. Battle of the boards favoring the Purdue Fort Wayne Mastodons, 17-12. Shatoya Sanders with 6 carries leading the way for the Mastodons. Leading rebounders for South Dakota, Madison McKeever and Kira Duffy with 3 apiece. Assists favor South Dakota, 6-4. They also lead in steals, 5-1. Turnovers, that's been a problem for Purdue Fort Wayne. They've turned it over 12 times, South Dakota just 4 times. And converting, by the way, we should also say that Purdue Fort Wayne leads in blocks 2-0, both of those blocks courtesy of Shatoya Sanders. Points off those turnovers favoring South Dakota 8-5. Points in the paint favoring South Dakota 14-8. They also lead in second chance points 5-2. Fast break points 2-0, but the Mastodon bench has outscored the Coyote bench 17-9. Again, it's 27-25 at halftime. Again, a year ago when these teams last played in February here, it was tied at halftime 34 apiece. And unfortunately, for Purdue Fort Wayne fans, South Dakota went on outscoring the Mastodons 24-8 in the third quarter and 13-7 in the fourth to win by a final score of 71-49. As we mentioned, opening game of the conference season for Purdue Fort Wayne. And game number 2 in league play for South Dakota. They knocked off Western Illinois last Sunday in Macomb, 96-65. Well, some news and notes. We talked about Hannah Albrecht leading Purdue Fort Wayne in scoring with 15 points. She did not play in the game on December 22nd at Butler, but the game prior to that, on December 13th, in a win over Evansville, she had a career-high 30 points, went 9 for 17 from the floor, 5 of 8 from three-point range, and 7 of 8 from the foul line. And 19 of those 30 points came in the second half. And 7 of those points came in a 14-0 Mastodon run when Purdue was on top by a bunch early. And Hannah Albrecht, a career-high 30-point performance against Evansville. Mastodon's enter play today, 3rd in the Summit League and 66th in the country in steals. Came into play having 116 steals in 13 games. And let's take a quick look again at the numbers here. They only have 1 so far today. That was by Shatoya Sanders. Out of Oppenkooper, 9th in the country and 2nd rather in the Summit League in minutes played this season. Coming into play today, she had played a total of 474-plus minutes, and in the first half, she has played just under 17 minutes. And in her career, Anna, 12th in program history in career minutes played, and she has played for over 3,000 minutes thus far as a Mastodon. By the way, guten Abend to her folks watching and or listening back in Germany. Meanwhile, little technical issues going on here as feverish efforts are being applied to try to get our monitor to work. And we'll see how that goes. Macedons have come back onto the court to get ready for the second half. Still waiting the arrival of South Dakota. By the way, this is the front end of a doubleheader at approximately 3 o'clock this afternoon. The men's teams from these universities will play each other. Again, it's the opening game in the conference for head coach John Kaufman. His men's team is 7-8. And for the Coyotes, well, they're 0-1 in the league. They lost at Western Illinois last Sunday. So, and then the teams go back on the road as I believe on Saturday the men will be at North Dakota, and on Sunday the women will be in Grand Forks, North Dakota to take on UND. Now here comes South Dakota back onto the court. A little over 2 minutes left until we start the second half of play. Let's take another timeout. Again, our halftime score, South Dakota 27, Purdue Fort Wayne 25. From Arnie Ball Court, this is Purdue Fort Wayne women's basketball.
Life is busy enough. And when you add finding a doctor, it can be overwhelming. Lutheran Health Network now makes it possible to find a doctor with just one phone call to 844-LHN-DOCS. One call lets you schedule an appointment with one of more than 50 primary care providers in our network. Just call 844-LHN-DOCS. Finding a doctor with just one call, that's life, powered by Lutheran. Lutheran Health Network includes physician-owned hospitals.
In its fourth decade, the Summit League continues its ascent through excellence in the classroom and success in the field of play. In cities big and small, at public and private universities, more than 120,000 students across 9 institutions reach for the Summit. From academic All-Americans to NCAA champions and nationally ranked teams, Summit League student athletes achieve the pinnacle of success. The Summit League, where tomorrow's leaders reach the summit today.
Second half, moments away from getting underway here at Arnie Ball Court. South Dakota, the preseason favorite to win the league, leading Purdue Fort Wayne, picked to finish last in the conference by a score of 27-25. Coyotes will have the ball to start the second half, going from right to left. And let's take a look. Hannah Shervin, Kira Duffy, Monica Arnes, Chloe Lamb, and Madison McKeever. And for Purdue Fort Wayne, Anna Lappin Cooper, Ellie Dykstra, Shatoya Sanders, Shayla Sellers, and Hannah Albrecht. So the starters who started the game for both teams starting the second half. Duffy on the right side, only had 4 points in the first half. Loses the ball, picks it back up, shoots a 17-footer, off the rim, no good. Sanders with their seventh rebound. Macedons with their first possession of the second half. Lappin Cooper crosses midcourt, picked up by McKeever. On the right side, Jibwish to the left. Now passes left side to Dykstra, who loses it to Duffy. Scrum on the floor, and Duffy wins it. Lamb crosses midcourt, passes left side to Duffy, picked up by Ellie Dykstra. We played 35 seconds. Duffy wants to go baseline. Dishes off to Shervin. Ball loose. Scrum on the floor. It'll be a jump ball, and the possession arrow favors Purdue Fort Wayne. We played 43 seconds of the second half. Neither team has scored. It's still 27-25 South Dakota. Shayla Sellers, whose dad played collegiately at Wisconsin and Ohio State and spent 13 years in the NBA. Inbounds it to Lappin Cooper. Up the right side, hands it off to Albrecht. Albrecht, top of the key pass to Sellers. Watched by Lamb. Shayla dribbles, kicks it off in the corner. Dykstra, baseline jumper, in and out, and again, no good. Lamb with the rebound. Outlet pass to the right side to McKeever. McKeever over midcourt, left side pass to Arns. Arns watched by Sowers. Back to McKeever, now they go right side to Lamb. Lamb, pull-up jumper, good. It's a two. Chloe Lamb with their second field goal, and the lead doubled from 2-4. It's now 29-25, South Dakota. Ellie Dykstra near the top of the key. Watched by Monica Arns, dribbles to the right, looking for Sanders. Lob pass in the block to Sanders. Toya wants to go to work on Shervin. Spin move, left-hand shot, too strong, no good. Rebound, Kira Duffy. Duffy brings it up the floor herself. Now left side pass to McKeever to Arns. Battle in the block between Sanders and Shervin, and the foul's going to be called on Chatoya Sanders. That is her second, team first of this third quarter. Comes at the 8-12 mark. Dykstra and Sanders out. Hannah Hess and Jazzy Hughes in. Duffy looking for a teammate in red. Kicks it back to McKeever. McKeever picked up by Albrecht. McKeever dribbles to the right, bounce pass right wing to Duffy. Lob pass in the block for Shervin. Fouled by Hughes. Shervin will shoot two. Jazzy Hughes with her third foul. Second team foul of the quarter on Purdue Fort Wayne. And going to the line for the second time today is Hannah Shervin. Hit one out of two in the first quarter. And averaging 12 points a game. And the first free throw is good. She now has six. Looking a 65% foul shooter, but she hits the second to make it 31-25. As South Dakota currently on a 6-0 run. Sellers, right side pass to Albrecht. Boy, could handle love to get untracked. To Hess, and they're going to call Hess for a travel. That is turnover number 14 on Purdue Fort Wayne here today. Chloe Lamb, watched by Loppenkooper, dribbles to her left, now passes to her right to Duffy. Duffy, watched by Hess. Lob pass inside to Shervin, left-hand shot off the glass and in. And Shervin, a definite height advantage, already has 4 points in this third quarter, had 5 points in the first half. Coyotes have opened up an 8-point lead, 33-25, 7:15 to go. 3-point shot by Sanders, no good. And here comes Kira Duffy. Left outlet pass to McKeever. McKeever picked up by Sellers. Back to Lamb, lob pass on the right block. Duffy off the glass and in. Might be a timeout called here. It's Kira Duffy now with 6 points. And indeed a timeout is called by Purdue Fort Wayne. With 6:58 left in this third quarter. Been a rough start for the Mastodons in this third quarter. They were down 27-25 at the half, but Coyotes have scored the first 8 points of the quarter to stretch that lead to 10. It's 35-25. And we will keep it here during this timeout. There's one other game scheduled in the Summit League play on this New Year's Day. Later tonight, out in Denver, the Pioneers will host North Dakota. Tomorrow, there are two games scheduled, Western Illinois at North Dakota State, Oral Roberts at South Dakota State. Then on Saturday, Western Illinois goes to South Dakota State, Oral Roberts goes to Omaha. And on Sunday, Denver is at South Dakota, and Purdue Fort Wayne is at North Dakota. That's a 2 o'clock tip. And that's what's happening through Sunday in Summit League play. Here again, it is South Dakota 35, Purdue Fort Wayne 25, with 6:58 left in the third quarter. It'll be Purdue Fort Wayne ball. And they need to get the offense started. Riley out off the bench, and she brings it up over midcourt. Again, a freshman from LaPorte. Picked up by McKeever. Top of the key pass to Albrecht. Hannah. And they're going to call a foul on Albrecht as she dished it off to Loppencooper. Player control foul. First on Hannah. Third on the team. So here comes South Dakota trying to stretch their lead from 10. Chloe Lamb at the foul line. Drives the lane. Left-hand shot too strong. Ball tipped away. Back to Duffy. Left side pass to Monica Irons. Inside to McKeever. Watched by Sanders. McKeever dishes back to Irons. Left side three off the rim. No good. Offensive putback by Lamb is good. Chloe Lamb with 6 points. Four coming in this quarter. And South Dakota's opened up a 12-point lead. It's 37-25. Macedon still looking for their first point of this quarter. Sanders top of the key, watched by Shervin. Right side pass to Albrecht. Albrecht, pullback jumper, off the iron, no good. Ball tipped away, picked up by Albrecht. Hands it off to Ott. 15 on the shot clock. Back to Albrecht. Pull-up jumper blocked by McKeever. Ball knocked away by Loppencooper, picked up by Albrecht. 17-footer swishes the cords. Hannah Albrecht with their first field goal of the day. And let's see if that opens up things. 37-27. Lead cut to 10. Duffy foul line extended right. Lob pass in to block Shervin. Blocked by Sanders. Deflects it to Loppencooper. Here comes Purdue Fort Wayne. Loppencooper right up the gut. Back to Albrecht. Three on the way. No, off the rim, no good. Shervin with the board. Ahead to Duffy. Duffy up the right side. Still with the dribble. Players. And a double foul, I think, is going to be called on Shervin and Sanders. They have been, for lack of a better phrase, butting heads all game long. So I believe a double foul, I believe, has been called. Brad Maxey heading. Yeah, they are going to call the double foul. Sanders and Shervin. Second foul on Shervin, third foul on Sanders. Coming with 4:59 left in this third quarter. By the way, that's just the first team foul on South Dakota, but it's the fourth team foul on Purdue Fort Wayne. And there'll be a media timeout as well. So let's take a break and see what develops. 4:59 left in the third quarter. South Dakota leading Purdue Fort Wayne 37-27. And from Arnie Ball Court, this is Purdue Fort Wayne women's basketball.
When it comes to breast health, early detection is key. At Lutheran Health Network, we offer mammography services at 9 convenient imaging locations throughout the region. Many locations offer 3D mammograms. No referral necessary. To learn more and schedule your mammogram, visit lutheranhealth.net/mammography. That's life powered by Lutheran.
Welcome back, everybody, to Arnie Ball Court. 4:59, time left in the third quarter. South Dakota has jumped out with a 10-2 run to start this third quarter to stretch their 2-point halftime lead. I should say 12-2. It is now 10 at 37-27. Double foul was called on Hannah Shervin and Chatoya Sanders prior to the timeout. South Dakota gets the ball on what turns into an alternate possession call. Ball knocked out of bounds. Coyotes now back in, inbounding it. Chloe Lamb. Taylor Frederick in the game. Back up top to Duffy. Duffy wants to go baseline. Watched by Loppen Cooper. Pull-up jumper is good. Duffy now with 8 points. Had 4 points in the first half. Has 4 points in the second. Averaging over 16 points a game this year. And the lead again a dozen at 39-27. Ah, into the right corner. Three-point shot. No good. Dykstra fighting for the offensive board. Ball tipped away and picked up by Loppen Cooper. Back to Riley Ott. Ott dribbles left, hands it off to Loppen Cooper. Now right side pass to Hess. Hannah drives the lane. She's a southpaw. Shot a little bit short, no good. Rebound by Chloe Lamb. Outlet pass to Arns up the left side. Now into the left corner to Duffy. Boy, stretching the legs, and she's got long legs, but she banks it off the glass and in. Duffy now in double figures with 10 points. 41-27, 3:50 left in the third quarter. South Dakota stretching it. Here's a steal, and now what are you going to call? You had Lamb and Albrecht smacking each other, and they're going to call the foul on Hannah Albrecht. That's her second. It's the fifth team foul, however. So free throws coming up at the 3:46 mark. It'll be Chloe Lamb. First trip to the line today, looking for point number 7. And she's got it. Lamb, 70% free throw shooter coming into the game, 14 out of 20. One more free throw coming. And that is good as well. 43-27. 16-2 run to start the third quarter for South Dakota. Ott drives the lane. High arching underhand bank shot. Good. 43-29. McKeever, left wing, watched by Albrecht, picked up by Hess. Lob pass in the left block to Frederick, and we're going to have a foul, I think, called on Dykstra. First foul on Ellie, the sophomore from Byron Center, Michigan. More free throws coming for the Coyotes at the 3:20 mark. As Taylor Frederick goes to the line for the first time, she will shoot two. Frederick on the year, a 77% free throw shooter, and she misses the first. As a team, South Dakota hitting over 75% of their free throw opportunities. And the second one here is good. So Frederick now with 7 points. Sowers back in. Hess, Ott, Sowers, Loppen Cooper, and Albrecht, the 5-4 Purdue Fort Wayne. Ott over midcourt, dribbles to the right. Pitches back to Albrecht, loose ball, errant pass. Scrum for it, and now whistle stops play. Foul going to be called on Chloe Lamb of South Dakota. Her second, team second of the quarter. So Purdue Fort Wayne will inbound the ball with 3:05 left. Trailing by a score of 44-29. And now they're going to reset the shot clock to 26 seconds. Loppen Cooper in front of her own bench to inbound the ball for Purdue Fort Wayne into Riley Ott. Ott dribbles to her left, kicks it back to Hess. And they're going to call a player control foul on Riley Ott. Foul similar to the one that Albrecht picked up earlier. So here comes South Dakota. They were only up by 2 at the break, but they now lead by 15, 44-29. Lob pass for Frederick, deflected by Hess into the hands of Ott. Ott up the right side of the floor. Dishes back to Albrecht. Top of the key, Hess. She'll launch a three. Around the rim and out, no good. Offensive rebound by Sellers. Back to Albrecht. Remember, on a rebounded shot, You only go back to 20 seconds and not 30. Now 8 on the clock. Lopping Cooper. Bounce pass to Ott. 5 on the clock. Ott drives the lane. Banks it in. And draws the foul. Foul is on McKeever. Her second, team third. And Riley Ott with a chance for a three-point play. Talented freshman from LaPorte. Looking for her ninth point, and she's got it. Now 44-32, 2:22 left in the third quarter. McKeever up the left side of the floor. Kicks it back out to Kira Duffy. Lob pass on the left block to Frederick. Shot no good. Gets her own rebound, and she is knocked to the floor, and I think the foul's going to be on Riley Ott. We'll double check. Yes, Mark Berger says number two is the foul. And that is her third. So, to the free throw line. Once again goes Taylor Frederick. You hit one out of two a moment ago. And hits the first one here. In and out with the second one. Arns tipped it back, but Frederick couldn't get it. Instead, it goes to Ott. Up the right side to Albrecht. Albrecht watched by Kira Duffy. Now they go left side, Lopping Cooper. Dribbles right, dribbles left, dribbles on the paint. Right-hand shot, not strong enough. Off the glass and off the rim, no good. Here's McKeever up the right side for the Coyotes. Right side pass, Lamb. Pass deflected by Sellers, intended for Frederick, picked up. Here's Lopping Cooper, kicks it back. Hess to Lopping Cooper. 90 seconds left in the quarter. Albrecht. Covered by McKeever to Hess. 10 on the shot clock. Top of the key pass, Lopping Cooper. Kicked it back. Hess back to Lopping Cooper. 3 on the way. Yes! Lopping Cooper for 3, her first points of the ball game. Dons were patient, and the patience paid off. Back to a 10-point deficit. Duffy long on a 3-point shot. Frederick an offensive rebound. Oh, they're going to call a foul. No, they're going to call traveling on Taylor Frederick. Mastodon fans happy for that. Liv Corngable checks in for South Dakota. And a timeout call, I believe. Well, I'm not sure who called that timeout. We do know a timeout was called with 58.1 seconds. And we think the timeout was called by the Mastodons. That'll leave Niecy Nelson with 2. And South Dakota still has their full complement of 4. Michelle Nichols has checked in for the first time. Michelle, a 5'10 junior, a transfer out of Philadelphia, Pennsylvania. Sellers inbounds the ball to Ott. Ott brings it over midcourt. Picked up by Chloe Lamb. High post pass to Hughes. Hughes watched by Shervin, who's back in the game. Back to Ott. In the paint. Left hand shot up and in. Riley Ott, 7-3 at third quarter points. And it's 45-37. The lead back into single digits. It's just 8 now for South Dakota. 45-37. 30 seconds left in the third quarter. Shervin, top of the key, left side pass to Lamb, inside for Duffy. Double team, turnaround jumble, short. Ball tipped away, fought for. Picked up by Corngable. 1/10 of a second difference, so South Dakota can basically play for the last shot. Down to 10 seconds in the quarter. McKeever, watched by Sellers, bounce pass right wing, Duffy. Duffy, lob pass inside, and a player control foul on Hannah Shervin. Her third. Comes with 3.4 seconds left. Fourth team foul. That'll bring Monica Irons back in for Hannah Shervin, who has 9 points but three personal fouls. Sellers to inbound the ball to Loppencooper. Two dribbles, three dribbles, forces up a shot off the top of the glass, no good. And the third quarter has come to an end. Big quarter for South Dakota as they outscore Purdue Fort Wayne 18-12. We go to the fourth. Coyotes 45, Mastodons 37. And from Arnie Ball Court, this is Purdue Fort Wayne women's basketball.
Hungry Howie's, how may I help you?
Hi, I'm here to pick up my $10 Hungry Howie meal deal.
Pizza night with a family?
Nope.
Taking it to a party?
Nuh-uh.
Eating all of it in your car and discard.
Did you know that 8 out of 10 Americans feel re-gifting is acceptable? This means there's only a 20% chance someone will actually keep your holiday gift. At least that's what they'll make you believe. The perfect way to prevent re-gifting this holiday season is to give the people on your list a washbook from Mike's Car Wash. A washbook from Mike's is the practical, affordable way to spread holiday cheer. Because everyone washes their car, right? Mike's is a proud sponsor of the Mastodons.
In its fourth decade, the Summit League continues its ascent through excellence in the classroom and success in the field of play. In cities big and small, at public and private universities, more than 120,000 students across 9 institutions reach for the Summit. From academic All-Americans to NCAA champions and nationally ranked teams, Summit League student-athletes achieve the pinnacle of success. The Summit League, where tomorrow's leaders reach the summit today.
In the books, 10 minutes or maybe more yet to be played here on this New Year's Day afternoon. South Dakota leading Purdue Fort Wayne 45-37. After three quarters of play, the Coyotes 18-44 from the floor for just under 41%. 2 of 8 from three-point range for 25%. 7 of 10 at the foul line for 70%. Kira Duffy with 10 points. Hannah Shervin with 9 and Taylor Frederick with 8 leading the way. That's Chloe Lamb also with 8 points. For Purdue Fort Wayne, 14-36 in the floor for just under 39%. 4 of 17 from 3-point range for 23.5%. 5 of 6 at the foul line for 83%. Purdue Fort Wayne led in scoring by Riley Ott, the freshman from LaPorte, with 11 points. It'll be Ott, Albrecht, Michelle Hughes. See who else is on the floor. South Dakota will have the ball to start the quarter. Nichols and Sellers. Chloe Lamb, and it looks like Purdue Fort Wayne wants to try to trap. Gets it to Arnes. Arnes, lob pass inside, knocked out of bounds. It'll stay with South Dakota. Pass intended for Kira Duffy. So you got Arnes, McKeever, Chloe Lamb, Duffy. Inbounds to Duffy, watched by Sellers, and they're going to call a reach-in foul on Shayla Sellers. Liv Corngable also on the floor to start the quarter. So Sellers picks up the foul, her second, team first of the quarter, 15 seconds into this fourth quarter. Duffy inbounds it to Monica Irons. Bounce pass to Lamb. Lamb picked up by Sellers. Left side, Duffy. Three on the way. Off the rim, no good. And over the back foul going to be called on Madison McKeever. And that is her third foul. First team foul in the quarter on the Coyotes. Tit for tat, if you will. Each team with a foul in the first 24 seconds. Ott. Bounce pass high post to Nichols. Nichols. Two dribbles, looks for help, kicks it back out to Albrecht. Boy, Hannah with just 3 points so far today. Back to Nichols. Right side, Sellers, 8 on the shot clock. Spin move by the freshman. She tried to hit out and threw it over her head out of bounds. 18th turnover on the Mastodons today. Gives the ball back to the Coyotes with 9:10 left to go South Dakota on top, 45-37. Lamb over midcourt, watched by Loppen Cooper. Gets past her, arching bank shot, no. Rebound, the freshman Shayla Sellers, ahead to the freshman Riley Ott. Crossing midcourt at the 8:52 mark. Macedon's down by 8, 45-37. Now to Albrecht. Albrecht wants to dribble to the right, cut off by Kira Duffy. Back to Nichols. Nichols almost walked, gives it back to Albrecht. Now Loppen Cooper, top of the key with 5 on the clock. Nichols, 4 on the clock, forces up a shot, knocked away by Arns. And South Dakota with a basketball. Clock down to 8:20. Skip pass into the left corner to Lamb. Into the block for Duffy. Wants to drive on Nichols. Turnaround jumper off the rim and in. Kira Duffy now with 12 points. 47-37, a 10-point Coyote lead. 8 minutes remaining here in the fourth quarter. Ott back to Albrecht. Dribbling to the right. And they're going to call a player control foul on Michelle Nichols. Her first, team second. .752 to go. South Dakota now up by 10, 47-37 with the basketball. Chloe Lamb over midcourt, right side pass to McKeever. McKeever, lob pass on the right block to Duffy. Back up top of the key, Arn. She'll launch a three. Short, off the rim. Rebound picked up by Loppen Cooper. The senior from Germany brings it over midcourt herself. On the left side. Oh, what a pass intended for Albrecht, but knocked away and picked up by Arns. Up ahead, right side to McKeever. Driving the lane. Left-hand shot, partially blocked by Sanders. Outlet pass to Ott. Back and forth we go. Loppen Cooper. Left side, Albrecht wants to go baseline. Shot up the glass and in. Albrecht, there's just her second bucket. She has 5 points. 47-39, 7 minutes to go. Liv Corngable, top of the key. Right side pass to Arns, now on the right wing to McKeever. Pull up jumper, good. Madison McKeever now with 4 points. And a timeout called by Purdue Fort Wayne. And I believe that may constitute the media timeout as well. 6:47 remaining. South Dakota 49, Purdue Fort Wayne 39. And I believe that Purdue Fort Wayne has just one timeout remaining. Officials are getting together for some reason. I'm not sure what. And I'm thinking a lot of teams didn't think that this game might be this close. Well, the new numbers, South Dakota, 20 of 50 from the floor for 40%, 2 of 10 from three-point range for 20%, 7 to 10 at the foul line for 70%. Kira Duffy with 12 points, the only Coyote in double figures. Purdue Fort Wayne, 15 of 38 from the floor for 39.5%, 4 of 17 from behind the arc for 23.5%, 5 of 6 from the foul line for 83.3%. They have one player in double figures as well, and that's the freshman Riley Ott with 11 points. Rebound battle right now favors Purdue Fort Wayne by just one, 26-25. Assist favors South Dakota by one, 8-7. Macedon's lead in blocks, 3-2. Big difference turnovers. South Dakota's turned it over just 10 times. Purdue Fort Wayne, 20 times. Points in the paint favoring South Dakota 26-18. Points off turnovers favors Purdue Fort Wayne 15-14. Macedon bench has excelled, outscoring the South Dakota bench 24-11. But it is the visitors from Vermilion, South Dakota, about 52, 53 miles west of Sioux Falls. They're looking for their 13th win of the year. As they're on top 49-39 with 6:47 to go. And South Dakota head coach Don Plitzuwhite talking with official Brad Maxey. And I'm not sure. Brad's the only official on the floor right now. Jamie Broderick and Mark Berger. No, there's Mark. We're playing hide and seek. That's where it was. I'm not sure why the added delay. Again, Purdue Fort Wayne 4-9 overall, South Dakota 12-2. And we mentioned these two teams will play each other one more time. And that will be on January 24th in Vermilion. Now I think we're ready. It'll be Mastodon ball. Jamie Broderick talking with Purdue Fort Wayne Athletic Director Kelly Hartley Hunter for a moment. Now we're back into play. Hannah Hess over midcourt. Dribbles to her right, now passes to Ott. Ott watched by Corn Gable, battle of number twos. Riley gave up the dribble. And she throws it on scrum on the floor. It'd be a jump ball, and possession arrow favors South Dakota at the 6:31 mark. And perhaps that might be labeled a freshman mistake. Got double-teamed in the corner. She will learn. Now they're going to say still Purdue Fort Wayne. And Ott from the right corner for three. Misses everything. Sanders tries to keep it alive and cannot. So here comes South Dakota. Kira Duffy over midcourt. Left wing pass to McKeever. Watched by Ott. McKeever drives around her and Sanders shot up and in. McKeever now with 6 points, four coming in this fourth quarter. 51-39, the lead back up to 12. Twice Purdue Fort Wayne had cut it to eight. Albrecht, Loppenkooper, who they're gonna call the foul on. They're gonna call Albrecht with another player control foul. Her third, two of her three have been the player control fouls. Third team foul, Hannah can't believe it. So South Dakota again with possession of the ball. Now less than 6 minutes remain. Duffy wants to go baseline, count the bucket, and there's a foul on a hesitation move. Foul is on Chatoya Sanders, her fourth. Team fourth. That'll bring Shayla Sowers off the bench. And you could say that was a senior move by Kira Duffy. A hesitation step. Going to the line for the first time today. Looking for her 15th point, and she gets it. 54-39. It was 47-38, not so long ago, but 7-1 run. They've given the Coyotes some breathing room. Sellers on the right side. Wants to drive, kicks it back to Albrecht. 10 on the shot clock. Boy, Duffy just hanging on to Hannah Albrecht. Can't get any room at all. 4 on the shot clock. Hess has got to force up a 3, hits the rim, no good. Boy, Hess and Lamb each hit the floor. No call by anybody. Irons gets a pass from McKeever. Drives to the basket. Draws the foul. Foul's going to be on Hannah Hess. Her first. Team fifth. And South Dakota goes back to the free throw line. And this time it will be Monica Irons shooting two. She has 5 points today, and all five of those points came in the first quarter. First free throw gets the friendly roll. 55-39. And the second free throw good as well. 56-39. Ott has it stolen by Lamb. Ahead to McKeever up the right side of the floor. Going to drive on Sowers. Deflected by Sowers. Loose ball scrum picked up by Shayla. Gives it to Bot Riley Ott. Back to Albrecht. Right side, Loppen Cooper. Into the right corner for Albrecht, and they're going to call Hannah for a travel. And I believe roughly that's the eighth or ninth travel call on Purdue Fort Wayne this afternoon. 4:37 remains. Jazzy Hughes in, Shayla Sellers out. Chloe Lamb with a clenched fist in her right hand. Brings it over midcourt. Now right side pass to Corngable. Inside pass to Duffy. Reverse layup is good. Now Kara Duffy didn't score much of the first half, but she's made up for that in the second. Now 58-39. Here's the freshman Ott. Hands it over to Loppen Cooper. Anna. Snap pass in the right corner for Albrecht. Her three off the rim, no good. Lamb with the rebound. Things going the way of the Coyote right now. Duffy attacks, pull-up jumper, good. Kara Duffy, 9 points in the quarter, 15 points in the half, 19 in the game. And it's 60-39 in the blink of an eye. Well, not so long ago, it was 47-38. Whistle away from the ball. And a foul is going to be called. And who is the foul on? There's no one out there, so we don't know who the foul is on. In any event, Purdue Fort Wayne with the ball. Ott tripped as she makes a drive to the basket by Corngable. That foul we know was Corngable. At the 3:26 mark. And now they're the previous foul at the 3:36 mark was called on Monica Arnes, evidently. In any event, Macedon's tried to inbound the basketball. Deflected pass picked up by Albrecht. And she loses it to McKeever. Up to Monica Arnes. Arnes on the right side, Corngable. Lob pass on the right block. Duffy shooting over Hughes and missing. A rare miss for Kira Duffy. Here is Hannah Albrecht. Bounce pass up the right side to Hannah Hess. Back to Albrecht. 3:05 left. 60-39, South Dakota with the lead. Nice pass to Loppen Cooper, back top of the key. Hess for three, no good. Out of bounds, last touch by Jazzy Hughes. And now there's blood noticed on the elbow of Madison McKeever. She will go to the bench and she will be replaced by Megan Bonar. Bonar is a 6'2 senior from Gardner, Kansas. 60-39, South Dakota on top. Clock showing 2:52 and running here in the fourth quarter. Duffy to Arnes. Arnes, long stretch, layup off the glass and in. Arnes now with 9 points. 62-39. Current 15-1 run by the Coyotes. Ott on the left side, dribbles to the right. Dribbles back out, passes to Loppen Cooper. 10 on the shot clock, jumper off the rim, no good. Rebound Kira Duffy. Pass intended for Chloe Lamb, inadvertently kicked by Anna Loppen Cooper. And now the bench being emptied a little bit. Jenna Yuzgeski and Macy Giebert making their first appearance of the day for South Dakota. Claudia Kunzer comes in as well. Corn Gable checks out, and also heading to the scorer's table is Alexi Kemp. And Hempy seeing action for the first time, a 5'11 freshman out of Fredericksburg, Virginia. Kunzer with the ball. Now pass on the right side to Yagetsky. Drive, shot missed by Giebert. Offensive rebound by Kunzer. Ball stays with South Dakota. Less than 2 minutes remain now. Coyotes comfortably in front, 62-39. Yagetsky bounce pass. Picked up by Kunzer, left side three. Off the rim, no good. Rebounded by Shatoya Sanders. And that'll put her in double figures in rebounds today. A bright spot for Purdue Fort Wayne. 1:35 to go, 62-39, South Dakota on top. Hannah Hess with the ball for Purdue Fort Wayne. Hannah's hit three threes today. Attacks the lane, gets it to Nichols. Off her leg out of bounds. With 1:20 left on the clock. Alexi Hempy will bring the ball up the right side. Now passes to Giebert. Bonar, watched by Sanders. They're in the 1 minute mark, time remaining in this one. Hempy spin move, ball knocked out of bounds by Michelle Nichols. The possession stays with South Dakota with 59.6 seconds to go. Inbounds pass. Scuffle on the floor. Who's got it? They're going to call a jump ball with 52.7 seconds, and the arrow favors South Dakota as Jazzy Hughes will check in for Purdue Fort Wayne. Shatoya Sanders checks out with 10 rebounds and three block shots today. Inbounds pass, quick shot. Yagetsky missed, no good. Hughes with the board. And they're going to call a jump ball with 48 seconds to go. Purdue Fort Wayne will put it into play. Riley Ott over midcourt. Hands it off to Hannah Hess. Hess hands it off to Hannah Albrecht. Running the weave. Ott, left side, Hess, thought about a three. Spin move, loses the ball, but she's fouled. Foul was going to be on Claudia Kunzer. Here's her first, I should say. 30 seconds to go. And Reagan Sankey will check in for Claudia Kunzer. Sankey, a 6 foot sophomore from Lincoln, Nebraska. Inbounds pass to Albrecht. Hannah just could not get on track. Nice inside feed to Nichols. Ball loose. And knocked out of bounds by South Dakota. 22 seconds to go. 13 on the shot clock. Otto inbound the ball for Purdue Fort Wayne. Looking for Albrecht. Gets it to Hannah. Jump shot good. So Albrecht credited with a bucket. She has 7 points. And Brad Maxey said to take 3 seconds off the clock, so it's showing 17.9. Coyotes can just run it out. We hope, we never know. Down to 10 seconds. Giebert with the ball, watched by Ott. Well, guess what? 3-point shot tried by Hempy, no good. Offensive rebound by Sankey, and that'll do it. So this game is over. And our final score is South Dakota 62, Purdue Fort Wayne 41. In the fourth quarter alone, Coyotes scored 17 points. And Purdue Fort Wayne, unfortunately, scored just 4. Players and coaches congratulating each other. With the win, South Dakota goes to 2-0 in Summit League play, 13-2 overall. And with the loss, Purdue Fort Wayne falls to 0-1 in conference play and 4-10 overall. We will take a break, and when we come back, we will chat with Mastodon assistant coach Keila Sims. Again, our final score today was Purdue Fort Wayne falling to South Dakota by a final score of 62-41. Post-game show coming up in a moment. It's from Arnie Ball Court. This is Purdue Fort Wayne women's basketball.
Life is busy. Most days you wake up, make the coffee, get the kids dressed, and get them out the door. With everything else there is to do in a day, finding a doctor can take a lot of time. You have to ask your friends for recommendations, search online, sort through results, and make a dozen phone calls. Lutheran Health Network now makes it possible to find a doctor with just one phone call. All you need is a single phone number, 844-LHN-DOCS. That's right, with one phone call, you can schedule an appointment with one of more than 50 primary care providers in the Lutheran Health Network. And with 20 locations throughout Allen County, there's a Lutheran Health physician close to you. Call 844-LHN-DOCS to find a new doctor or make an appointment. Finding a doctor with just one phone call? That's life. Powered by Lutheran. Lutheran Health Network includes physician-owned hospitals.
Our story begins in 1929, the greatest financial challenge in American history. Stock markets crashed, banks failed, the nation plunged into a decade-long depression. But the story doesn't end there. In the midst of that depression, a group of employees at the Fort Wayne GE plant joined together to organize a credit union, a nonprofit, member-owned alternative to banks. They did business out of a shoebox, loaning money neighbor to neighbor when times were tough. Midwest America Federal Credit Union was born. We've grown a lot since those early days. Today, Midwest America offers everything you come to expect from a modern financial institution. But we haven't forgotten our history. And since 1936, we've invested in the community we call home. Life is unpredictable. You need a financial partner you can depend on. Join today and learn why three generations of hardworking families have put their trust in Midwest America. Midwest America Federal Credit Union. For your family, for the future.
In its fourth decade, the Summit League continues its ascent through excellence in the classroom and success in the field of play. In cities big and small, at public and private universities, more than 120,000 students across 9 institutions reach for the Summit. From academic All-Americans to NCAA champions and nationally ranked teams, Summit League student-athletes achieve the pinnacle of success. The Summit League, where tomorrow's leaders reach the summit today.
Welcome back, everybody, to Arnie Ball Court here inside the Hilliard Gates Sports Center on the campus of Purdue Fort Wayne. I'm Mike Maz, and our first game of this doubleheader on this New Year's Day afternoon is in the books on the women's side. The preseason favorites to win it all in the Summit League, the 24th-ranked Coyotes from the University of South Dakota, had a struggle through three-plus quarters, but they pulled away in the fourth quarter, outscoring the Mastodon 17-4 to win by a final score of 62-41. Waiting for assistant coach Akila Sims to come by and chat with us, but while we wait for her, a quick recap. 13-11 USD after the first quarter. Each team scored 14 points in the second quarter, so at halftime it was a 27-25 lead. South Dakota opened things up a little bit in the third and would end up outscoring Purdue Fort Wayne 18-12 to take a 45-37 lead into the fourth. These teams scored a couple of points early in the fourth quarter, and it was 47-38. But then South Dakota took off, and again, Macedon's just really, then we got two buckets in the quarter, both by Hannah Albrecht. Meanwhile, Kira Duffy, preseason player of the year in the Summit League, was held in check pretty much. 2 points in the first quarter, 2 points in the second, hit three buckets in the third, but in the fourth quarter she would score 9 points to lead the charge. And again, final score, Coyotes 62, Mastodons 41. Final numbers in the ballgame, South Dakota, 25 of 61 from the floor for 41%, just 2 of 12 from three-point range for 16.7%, and they were 10 of 13 from the foul line for just under 77%. They were led in scoring by Kira Duffy, who had 19 points on 9 of 19 shooting and 1 of 1 from the foul line. 9 points apiece for Hannah Shervin and Monica Arns. 8 points apiece from Chloe Lamb and Taylor Frederick, leaving 6 points for Madison McKeever and 3 points for Liv Corngable. For the Mastodons, they were 16 of 44 from the floor for 36.4%, 4 of 21 from three-point range for 19%, 5 of 6 on the foul line for just over 83%, and all six, five of the six free throw attempts took place in the first half. Macedon's had one player in double figures, freshman Riley Ott, with 11 points. 9 points for Hannah Hess on 3 three-point field goals. One came in the first quarter, two of those came in the second. 7 points from Shatoya Sanders, 7 points from Hannah Albrecht, who averaged 15 points a game coming into the contest, leaving 4 points for Jazzy Hughes and 3 points for Anna Loppencooper. Battle of the boards went to South Dakota today, 32-30. And the leading rebounders for the Coyotes, Madison McKeever and Kira Duffy, each with 6. Shatoya Sanders led everybody in rebounds with 10. Assists favored Purdue Fort Wayne, 9-8. Steals favored South Dakota, and they got a lot of them late, 10-5. Blocks 4-2 in favor of Purdue Fort Wayne, including 3 from Shatoya Sanders. Turnovers a big part of the story today. South Dakota turned it over just 10 times. Purdue Fort Wayne 25 times. And points in turnovers overall favored South Dakota 19-15. Points in the paint favored the Coyotes 36-18. They also led in second chance points 8-5 and fast break points 4-0. The Macedon bench outscored the Coyote bench today 24-11. And up until the very end, again, lead early in the fourth quarter was down to 8 at 47-38. But then the rest of the way, getting a 15-2 run to close things out for the South Dakota Coyotes. Well, still waiting to see if assistant coach Akilah Sims will be with us. I don't want to hold you up too much longer. We'll say next up on the docket for the Mastodons, a trip to Grand Forks, North Dakota. On Sunday afternoon, they will take on the Fighting Hawks from North Dakota, a 2 p.m. tip. Then they will be in Macomb, Illinois, 1 week from tomorrow, next Thursday night. They'll take on the Leathernecks from Western Illinois for an 8 p.m. tip. Our next broadcast of Purdue Fort Wayne women's basketball will be on January the 12th when the South Dakota State Jackrabbits come to town. That will be a 2 p.m. tip. And then after that, a matchup with the Golden Eagles from Oral Roberts. That'll be on January 16th, a 7 o'clock tip-off. So that's what's just ahead for the Purdue Fort Wayne women's basketball team. And I'm going to take one more look. The men's team already above Pavot School is warming up. Their game's scheduled to start in just over 39 minutes. We'll wrap it up. Hopefully we'll catch Akilah on another occasion. But thanks to the Purdue Fort Wayne Athletic Department, headed by Athletic Director Kelly Hartley Hutton, Sports Information Department Aaron Johnson supplies us with all kinds of great information. Thanks to our friends at Clearfield Sports IMG College, and also our friends at YouTube. I'm Mike Maas. Again, our final score today, South Dakota 62, Purdue Fort Wayne 41. Please enjoy the rest of your New Year's Day. And join us again on January 12th. We'll come on the air just a little before 2 o'clock when the Jackrabbits from South Dakota State come to Arnie Ball Court. Again, our final score this afternoon, the 24th ranked Coyotes of South Dakota 62, the Purdue Fort Wayne Mastodons 41. As we say, Happy New Year once again and goodbye to all from Arnie Ball Court here inside the Hilliard Gates Sports Center on the campus of Purdue Fort Wayne in Fort Wayne, Indiana.